and it included looking at all of these servers for controlled data from China. And I was like, okay, because now I knew how to use SigWin and write little scripts, I was an expert. So I was like, I can take this one on. So I walked down the hall to the local expert, Malcolm Heath. He happens to be sitting right here. And I told him my problem. Like, I can solve this. Like, how do I do this? What is your advice? And he suggested, you know what? You might look into Perl and use regular expression. I'd never heard Perl and I'd never heard regular expression. But I actually decided that I was going to learn both of those things. So I spent like the next, who knows how long, weeks, sitting down with all the tutorials online that I could find. I joined all the listservs of all the experts for all the Perl modules, and I dug in. So I don't know if you can actually read that, but this is actually proof that I did it, because I sent my old friend Scott an email that said, I am doing a tutorial on Perl right now, smiley face. This is so awesome. The other thing that I noticed when I was preparing for this talk is that you'll see the date is actually today's date 12 years ago, which is a little bit scary. So I felt like I was ready to go. So I built my script, started working, and then I got paired up with this awesome engineer in Poland. He introduced me to Subversion. And so the two of us were like checking in code in and out, and we were making this thing so awesome. And it was actually so effective and automated so well that we won a department recognition award, which was pretty cool back in those days. Then I got that award and decided to peace out and get another job. So I then went to another company and became a Windows Systems Administrator. And this story is not going to keep going, I promise. But you're probably wondering, like, so what? How did it change my life? Well, let me just say that through that experience, I learned the importance of automating everything. Because if you can automate something, that means you're making room for yourself to do something else. And in a way, I was automating myself into my next job, because my old job was actually now automated. I could do something even more important. It also taught me how to think logically. Before this experience, I did not know about case statements or if statements or loops, and thinking through things methodically like that allows me to actually problem solve a lot differently and more effectively in all kinds of ways. Fundamentals are so critical. There is no way that I could have worked with this seasoned engineer from Poland and built this really great automation if I didn't understand the basics and how important it is to build on those. And I also learned that there is community for everything, because I spent countless times emailing these listservs and getting not only fast responses, but correct answers with explanations that really helped me understand. Okay, so back to where we started. Yes, I'm a mother. I also chose to marry someone who supported me in almost everything, well, in everything I've decided to do. Get my servers on Big Brother, learn Perl, and support me in founding Portland Women in Technology. As someone who has a technical background, I can now manage highly technical people. I'd like to think quite effectively. And because community was such an important part of my journey in coding, it actually formed the early seeds to how important community can be in almost everything in your life, which was the basis for founding PDX Women in Tech. All right, so remember back in 2005 when I said that I might look really confident, but was pretty scared shitless? Well, actually today, I'm no longer scared shitless. I feel kind of smart and confident. And that is all I have. Thank you.